Welcome back to 7 Minutes for Seniors. I'm Chris Wilson. I'm here with John Reardon, the area's reverse mortgage specialist. We've already established that Florida is full and John is a good guy. So how specifically do you, in your job, help seniors in our area? How do you help seniors, right? I wouldn't be talking to you if you didn't help them.
Absolutely.
Right?
Yes. Seniors is my core product, the reverse mortgage. Mm-hmm. And just like you, the majority of your clients are seniors,
right?
Because that's when they really need help
for
your needs. So so I'm a specialist in reverse mortgages, which is a type of mortgage.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I say that because people hear the word reverse mortgage and some people have a negative connotation of it, which is fair enough, but it's okay. So what I do is I help people borrow money from their home if they're living on a fixed income.
Right.
So if you think about it, because again, I'm knowledgeable about all different kinds of mortgages. Don't forget, if you think about it, there's different kinds of mortgages for different people.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. There's VA loans for veterans.
Right.
See, there's FHA loans that are FHA insured. And maybe you need for new home buyers, 3.5% down. Then there's conventional loans where different credit scores. So the reverse mortgage is called a HECM, home equity conversion mortgage, and it's an FHA insured loan with a lending limit up to, I think it's $1.1 million or so. The lending limit is right up in that. So people within home ranges going all the way up to, it's 1.1 something million. They just changed it.
Okay.
The HECM lending limit is what it's called for FHA.
Okay.
HECM, again, is home equity conversion mortgage, which is the technical name for a reverse mortgage. So I help homeowners age 62 and older with the reverse mortgage. And your question was, how do I help seniors in that age group?
Yeah.
The reverse mortgage allows people to borrow, homeowners age 62 and older, to borrow money based on their age and the value of their home, So starting at age 62, you could borrow a certain percentage of the value of the home in a reverse mortgage to use it to live on.
Anything you want to?
No, it's a lending guideline from HUD.
Okay.
So 62-year-olds can borrow a certain percentage of the value of the home.
But what do they
have, and then
to,
the
they
older,
have to use it for
then,
something specific?
They could use it for whatever their needs are.
Okay.
Okay, but it starts at age 62.
Right.
Okay. But then, as you get older, you can borrow a little bit higher percentage of the home value.
Now, is it
so
a,
an,
is
so
it a line
70,
of credit? Or?
Yeah, right, they can put it into a line of credit.
Okay.
Absolutely. So so a 75-year-old would borrow a higher percentage of the home value than a 62-year-old could.
Okay. See?
Because the older you are, you can get a little bit more money in the reverse mortgage. An 80-year-old could get a little bit more than a 75-year-old.
Okay.
So I have a reverse mortgage program that tells me how much money somebody can borrow in a reverse mortgage. And then so then I what I do is I consult with people. If they feel like they're living on a fixed income,
this is
where I feel I really am very helpful for people. Like you feel, Chris, with your line of work, right?
Yeah.
Wait, right?
Oh, yeah.
Where you help them with your services
and
you get their house safer for them. And then you do home modifications too.
Right.
And of course, people pay you for that service.
Right.
So I do it with kind of helping people access some of the equity from their home. And I help them get money.
Right.
To use while they're alive. So some people are just living on their Social Security checks.
Right.
And maybe a pension. But again, the majority of people, as you know, because you help people all the time, they're just living on their Social Security checks.
Right.
That's the majority of people.
And they can't work. You can't work overtime at being a senior and get more money.
Right, right.
Yeah.
And then people have retired now, so they're not working as much.
Right.
So really, they're limited on what they can do because they're just living under Social Security checks. Okay.
And so your ideal client is not somebody who's looking at holding on to their house and passing on that legacy money to their kids. They're really looking to use that money to take care of themselves, maybe decrease their burden on the family.
Correct.
You know, use the equity in their home. And
right.
then,
right.
so your ideal client, obviously, as you've already said, is somebody over 62.
Right.
Right.
And to put it a little bit more into the same answer to your question, So say like a 70, 75-year-old is going to borrow, again, according to the lending limits, the lending rules of HUD
right.
and FHA, because it's very regulated and controlled loan because it helps seniors.
Right.
So it's very regulated, actually.
Have to make sure it's not predatory or anything.
Absolutely,
like that.
Absolutely. It's very regulated. So if you're talking to somebody like me, I'm very regulated with oversight to make sure we're always operating professionally according to the rules. So like a 70, 75-year-old is going to borrow about 50% of the appraised value of the home.
Oh, wow.
Right. And then there's closing costs, which it's like a refinance. So all these things have to be disclosed to people. And then I show them how much money they can get at closing.
Right.
So people can choose to take money at closing.
Can they use that? Can they use part of the home equity to pay the closing costs? Or do they have to have that separate liquid asset?
So the closing costs are subtracted from the gross amount they're receiving in the reverse mortgage.
So they're not going to have
and then they get a net amount. Correct.
Gotcha.
Correct.
Gotcha. Okay.
There's two items that people normally pay for with the reverse mortgage process. One is a counseling session. Everybody getting a reverse mortgage has to do a counseling session by a HUD certified third party. And we have to give them a list of counseling agencies that serve the area. And it typically runs about $130 to $140. So they pay for that.
Is there they a have test to get a counseling certificate. Session,
no. It's just to go over everything.
Just to make sure that
I was honest with everything I presented, to make sure that they understand what they're going through, that they understand it's a checks and balance because they have to get a counseling certificate.
Right.
And because don't forget, sometimes people in this age group, some of them might start having dementia.
Right.
And Alzheimer's.
And they could still be making decisions like this.
Correct.
Yeah. Not so, maybe fully understand what they're signing up for.
Correct. Many times I sit with people and there'll be a husband and wife and they're getting the reverse mortgage and one of the spouses has dementia. And then I have to double check to make sure that they have a power of attorney to make the decision for the spouse. Correct,
yeah.
For the signature.
Yeah.
So there's some, even though you and I relax and even joke around when we're networking and such. No, but you both you and I have to have serious standards.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely. Even with you do. So the core of our service, the helping people, is there's serious standards that we have to, adhere to.
Right.
Absolutely. And that's one of them. So again, starting at age 62, you can get a certain amount of money. They can borrow it. I have to show all closing costs. I have to show how much money they're going to get. I go over all that. There's counseling. And then so that's the sort of one item that they pay for out of their pocket, the counseling session, about $130, $140. And then the other one is the appraisal on the house.
Right.
And then that's the final amount. It's an FHA appraisal. And then that's the going rate for the appraisals in the area.
Yeah.
During when there was a really strong housing boom, I think the appraisals went up to $750, $800.
Wow.
But I think they backed down a little bit now to $550 and $650 and such.
Yeah.
But we don't make money on that. But the people have to pay for that too.
Right.
And that will dictate how much what their appraisal is.
Right.
For the money that they're going to receive in the reverse.
And obviously they can't participate in this if they don't have active homeowners insurance.
Correct. Right. So then the rules of the reverse mortgage are they can borrow this certain amount of money. I show them how much they would get. And then they don't have to make payments on it. This is why people choose to do a reverse mortgage.
Right.
It's like a home equity loan. But if you get a home equity loan from the bank, if you borrow money for the bank, you have to make payments on what you borrow.
Yeah. See? The bank wants their money back.
Correct. You got to make monthly payments on what you borrow. So the government created this reverse mortgage. So it's a home equity loan. And the rule is you don't have to make payments on it.
Right.
As long as you live in the home, have homeowners insurance, and pay your property taxes, and keep the home in good condition. You don't make payments on the reverse mortgage. That's why people do the reverse mortgage.
Right.
So they can borrow the money, use it to help live on.
Right.
Because they're living on that fixed income, Social Security checks.
Right.
Borrow the money now. Use it in however they need to use it. And then they don't have to make payments on the money in the reverse mortgage. There's an interest rate attached to it, the money that they're using.
Right. And that interest and then compounds every month.
Compounds every month, right. Which they get monthly statements of right. what their reverse mortgage is. And then at the end, when they pass away, they can leave the house to the kids.
Right.
And because they only borrowed maybe about 50% of the appraised value, typically there's still equity left at the end.
Right.
So then there'll be a loan balance. Kids get the house. And then they have up to 6 months to list and sell the house.
Okay.
When the house sells at market value, the house will sell. Then the kids know that they have to pay back what the parents owed.
Right. Okay.
And then that's how it's settled. So a lot of people think that when people do a reverse mortgage, the bank gets the home. The bank, the people lose the property. The bank takes the home from
right.
them. That's one of the negative misconceptions or connotations that people think. But it's a misconception. That's not a true
right.
statement.
Yeah.
Thankfully, in Florida and in the United States, we have private property rights, right? So if somebody owns a piece of property, so with a reverse mortgage, it's like taking out a loan against it or a home equity loan. So when somebody passes away, there's a loan balance due, but we don't seize the property.
Right.
It goes to the heirs. So I always tell people, just like when you're meeting with people, you want to give advice sometimes too when you're helping people.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But you're not a lawyer.
No.
But you always say, consult a lawyer, you know, if
oh, yeah.
you know, right?
Yeah.
Which
especially with
do.
Probate and everything.
Right, exactly.
Like yeah.
But sometimes you might wind up talking about that.
Right, yeah.
With people, right?
Yeah.
Because, right. And same thing with me. So when I'm talking with people, I generally tell them, make sure you have a last will and testament if you want to leave your home
yeah.
to these heirs.
Right.
Yeah. Otherwise,
if nobody knows who the money who is supposed to go to, then.
Then it, probate becomes
yeah,
a mess.
Exactly.
Right. So yeah. so that's what we do. So reverse mortgage, yeah. Allows people to borrow a certain amount of money, use it, and that's really basically what a reverse mortgage is.
Awesome.
In discussion, yeah.
All right. Take a moment and tell everybody how they can get a hold of you.
Oh, I thought so. Okay.
The best way is you can go. I like Facebook platform.
Thanks,
yeah.
The best. Just go John Reardon.
Yes.
All right, Bubba. See
you. Easy, Bubba.
See you. John Reardon on Facebook, St. Augustine. And then I also have John Reardon Loan Officer on Facebook. And then I have my phone number, 904-982-2210 is my my cell phone. And then my email, johnreardon@loandepot.com. So there's many different ways. And if, but that's it. I think Facebook is a good platform. And that's how you and I
yeah.
stay in contact with each other a lot.
Typically.
On Facebook.
Or at the beginning of the month when we get to all these networking
meetings. Right, and then we see each other at the networking meetings.
Yeah.
And then when we talk about different clients with each other. So we're... Yeah.
Absolutely.
But again, we've known each other for a long time, so it's good. We could feel trust
confidence.
Each other. Confident
yeah, absolutely.
Other.
Yeah. Absolutely.